Hello and welcome to Grizzly's video bandsaw tracking and coplanar adjustment. My name is Kent and this is one in a series of how-to videos we're producing, making it easier for our customers to upgrade and maintain their Grizzly equipment. This is Sean, an engineer here at Grizzly. Together, we'll show you how to properly track your bandsaw blade. We'll also show you how to check and adjust your wheels to make sure that they are coplanar. This video is designed to give you an overview of the procedure and to help you visualize the process. It should be used in conjunction with the written instructions that came with your bandsaw. We recommend that you watch this entire video and read these instructions thoroughly before beginning this job. You can also reach our technical support at 570-546-9663 or text support at grizzly.com if you need further assistance. But most important, remember to follow all shop safety procedures. And remember, there are no more important safety devices than these. Blade tracking is affected by the tilt of the upper wheel, known as center tracking, and the alignment of both wheels, known as coplanar tracking. The wheels on this bandsaw were adjusted at the factory, so center tracking is the only adjustment that will need to be performed when the saw is new. Note that changes in width, type, and tension can affect blade tracking. For best performance, regularly check and maintain proper blade tracking. To center track the blade, no tools are required. The first step is to disconnect the bandsaw from the power source. Adjust the upper and lower blade guides away from the blade so they don't make contact with it and possibly affect your adjustment. When adjusting the blade tracking, the blade must have a reasonable amount of tension to simulate operating conditions. Move the quick release lever up to the vertical position, then use the blade tension adjustment knob to bring the red marker to the correct line on the tension scale for the width of the blade that is installed. Pull the tension quick release lever down to the horizontal position to apply tension to the blade. Spin the upper wheel slowly by hand at least 3 times and watch how the blade rides on the crown of the wheel. The crown is the curved part of the wheel surface that helps the bandsaw blade stay centered. If the blade rides in the middle part of the crown, the bandsaw is already tracked properly and no additional adjustments are needed. If the blade does not ride on the center of the crown, then you will need to adjust it. The blade tracking adjustment knob on the rear of the saw controls the tilt of the upper wheel, which, in turn, controls the center tracking of the blade. Unlock the blade tracking adjustment knob. Then spin the upper wheel with one hand and use the blade tracking adjustment knob with the other hand to make the blade ride in the center of the bandsaw wheel tire. When the blade consistently rides in the center of the wheel after several rotations, lock the blade tracking adjustment knob to secure the setting and close the upper wheel cover. Adjust the blade guides using the instructions in your manual. They should be set so they support the blade when cutting, but do not alter its position. About 4/1000ths of an inch gap on the sides and 16/1000ths at the rear is the normal spec for most saws. Wheel alignment is one of the most critical factors for optimal performance from your bandsaw. Wheels are properly aligned when they are parallel with each other and in the same plane, or coplanar. Heat, vibration, wandering, blade wear, tire wear, and overall bandsaw wear are significantly decreased when the wheels are parallel and coplanar. Additionally, wheels that are parallel and coplanar automatically track the blade to the center of the crown. This is called coplanar tracking. The tools needed to check and adjust the wheel alignment are a straight edge that is long enough to span both wheels, a fine ruler, a set of hex wrenches, and a wrench or socket to remove the wheel if it needs to be shimmed. Bringing the wheel into alignment may require a combination of shimming a wheel frontward or backward into the same plane as the other wheel, and vertical and lateral adjustments of the upper wheel to make it parallel with the lower wheel. To check the wheel alignment, first make sure the bandsaw is disconnected from the power source. Open both upper and lower front covers and remove the blade. Then remove the table so the straight edge can be set across both the upper and lower wheel. Reinstall the blade and make sure it is properly tensioned. Hold the straight edge close to the center of both wheels. It should touch the top and bottom rim of both wheels. Now move the straight edge to either side a few inches and check if it still lines up the same. If it does, then the wheels are coplanar and parallel and no further adjustment is required. If the straight edge does not touch the top and bottom rim of both wheels, then you will need to make some adjustments. The first adjustment is to make sure the wheel is parallel vertically. Place the straight edge in the center and use the blade tracking knob on the back of the saw to adjust it. If one wheel is sitting further back than the other, use the fine ruler to measure at the top and bottom of that wheel until the distance is the same. If the upper wheel is tilted laterally or side to side, there are two set screws that are used to adjust it. To get to them, first remove the blade, then remove the upper wheel. Thread one set screw out and thread the other set screw in the same amount to adjust the wheel. Adjust a little bit at a time, as small adjustment can have a big effect on the position of the wheel. Put the upper wheel back on the shaft and reinstall the blade. Check the alignment again and then repeat this procedure until the upper wheel is laterally parallel with the lower wheel. Once the wheels are set parallel, both vertically and laterally, the last adjustment is to set the two wheels coplanar. This is done by shimming behind the wheel that is set further back to bring it forward and in line with the other. With the straight edge touching both rims of the wheel that is further forward, measure the distance from the straight edge to the other wheel with a fine ruler. This distance is the amount the wheel must be shimmed. Remove the blade and then remove the wheel to be shimmed. Place the appropriate amount of shimming washers onto the wheel shaft, then reinstall the wheel and tighten the shaft nut. Reinstall and tension the blade. Then double check that both wheels are now parallel and coplanar with each other. Once you're satisfied with your adjustments, close the doors, reinstall the table, and test run the machine. If everything checks out, adjust the blade guides, and you're finished. Now, let's make some sawdust.